So today we are going to see about creating delightful human experiences using social-centered design approach, right? So from the JASI title, which is split up all the terms here. So it's about social impact, the human design, and then delightful experiences, right? So these are the key terms that we're going to see in the entire presentation. Okay, so designers have always designed a lot of things for bringing an impact, let's say revenue impact for the companies and the customer impact, marketing. So lots of impacts we have tried to bring it up. But what have we done for the society? Right, if you see the common people or the communities within them. So that is the question we wanted to raise here. So for this, we are coming up with a new process called social-centered design process, which has three modules, basically inspiring, ideating, and implementing. We'll quickly see how the process goes, powered by a case study that was done by us. So the first thing, what you have to do in the process is to frame your design challenge. So in your day-to-day life, you have seen a lot of problems, right? So you see here, it's a traffic jam, right? So we used to commute through the traffic jam, but we never thought that this is a problem that has to be solved. Or let's say garbage dumping, right? So we have seen garbage dumping everywhere, but have you ever thought about doing a design solution for this problem? Or food wastage. There is a place where there is excess of food, and there is a place where there is no food. Have you ever thought about connecting these two dots from the design perspective? Or let's say people in the streets without proper sanitation, proper hygiene, food or shelter, right? Have you ever thought about all these social problems that are hindering us, which we come across every day, right? So the first thing you do is to get inspired from the society you live in. There are millions of problems, right? And then the next thing you do is to form a team of mixed people. It is not only about designers who can solve the problem. You need people who can code, who can develop an app or something like that to solve the problem. People who need to fund it, people who implement it, right? So there are lots of stages. So you need to come up with a design team like this. So this is our team, my previous company's team. So you see, I'm there in the team. So this is like people who can code, who can design, all the stuff. So mix it, people. Mix it. And then the next thing is that you find your audience. So whom you're going to design, right? So if there is a traffic problem, it is faced by all the common people, right? And then it has to be very particular. You cannot design for something happening in Hyderabad by interviewing people in Chennai, right? So you need to know what is the agenda you're going to do, what is the target audience who are facing the problem. And then the most important part of this whole process is getting immersed into the lives, right? If you're doing something for a village, people get into the village, stay there, know what is the problem, actually live with the problem, and then you have to come up with the solution. It is not about interviewing 100 people, it's about interviewing the right 10 people. Once you interview, you get a lot of insights, right? So you take it back to the team, you prioritize group and strategize it. You say what is the highest priority, what is the lowest priority to be solved in the problem, and then you prioritize it. And the next is obviously the brainstorming. You come up with all kinds of solutions for the problem, right? It could be financially not possible, could be economically not feasible, technically not feasible, or it costs too much. That doesn't matter. Come up with all possible solutions for the particular problem. Once you have sorted out all solutions, pick up the most viable and prototype to integrate the people's feedbacks. You get awesome feedback from people, and then you need to integrate it, and then you actually build up your solution better. So the last step, we implement, monitor, and evaluate the impact. So there are lots of NGOs who have done all these things, so I'll see a few examples. So this one is called Project Help Desk. This is like multi-utility cardboard project that was done for school kids. It can be used as an item table and backpack. So this is called Hippo Water Roll Project for people in Africa, done by an NGO organization for picking up water from wrong places. This is called Life Straw. Economical water purifier. You can just suck the water from any water source and automatically get purified, right? It's all focused on a very particular set of people who are facing the problems, not the whole world. That is actually the niche thing about it. And this is called Wayfinder app for the visually impaired people. Okay? For closed spaces. So when you are into a railway station or into a shopping mall or a theater, right? So it actually tells you how many steps you need to take to the counter and stuff like that. So this is one more interesting project called Fiddle for the visually challenged kids. So it is actually combined with the Braille language with the form. So if you see, it's in the shape of fish and the Braille language says FISH. So they can easily understand and learn. This is called Out of the Box, a smartphone user manual for the elderly people. So if you see, it's very much focused on the elderly people. because we are all used to smartphones, right? So this is like having a placeholder in the center. You put your phone in the center and then you flip the pages and it says where to click and how it works. So these are all very easy and, you know, very nice solutions for us to represent. We picked up a nice problem from the society. How we made supermarkets billing counters less crowded. So billing counters being crowded is not a big problem, right? Have you ever thought that is a problem? Yeah, so if you see, long queues for billing one or two products first year customers. So that is the problem depth. If you see, if you're like purchasing only two items in the shopping mall and you need to stand for 30 minutes in the counter, that will be a big problem for you. So maybe we are youngsters, we could stand, but what about the elderly people or what about the physically challenged people who need to stand for a long time, right? So what would be a quick solution? So when I post this question, people were like, this is not a big deal, we can increase the number of bill counters, or we can put express counters. Because we all know about express counters, right? Less than 1 to 5 items, you can go to the express counter. But it did not work. If it would have worked, right, we would have not have a lot of queues there. So we came up with a set of questions that has to be posed to the users. So we went to malls like Big Bazaar, Neil Gris, and then Spar, all those malls around the city, Chennai. And then we posed all these questions to them. We had a mix of audience, like, you know, a housewife, a working professional, and then a senior citizen. Senior citizens were mostly, you know, they were like grooming, saying that, you know, I can stand for a long time. It's like painful for me to stand and do things like that. And then we went to the shopkeepers, went to the shop managers, went to the workers and asked, what is the problem? Why are you not taking a solution for this? And they said, we actually implemented a lot of solutions, but it still did not work. The findings from the people, we actually stood in lines for 30 minutes to build the products, the peak hours and stuff like that. And then all the findings we came up, and then we were like, you know, forming a brainstorming session, and then we connected all the dots. So these were the themes we identified. We wanted to focus the solution for purchasing less items. It has to be beneficial for the elderly and the physically challenged people, and it should benefit the business. It should not be cost consuming, or, you know, not feasible at all. It has to be a proper optimization of the process and also easy to implement. So this is our team at work for the design solutions. This was apparently all the solutions we got, like our scripts of all kinds of solutions we came up with. And then the final viable product which we thought would be a mobile app to scan product barcode and pay through the app. Right? This was a very simple solution that would easily be implemented. This is there in US, but, you know, India hasn't adopted this kind of infrastructure yet. So we made a quick paper prototype. If you see, the user is using it in the supermarket. He's trying to figure out how to use the app, right? And then, so this is what we thought. We got the feedbacks, and we said, people said that don't make the single app for a single supermarket, make it universal so that the user can use the same app for every supermarket. So once you enter, it actually detects the store and then it automatically selects and connects the inventory of the store. And then you can start, you know, scanning your barcodes and adding it to the cart. And then you finally pay and then you check out. This will be an universal app. So this is not the only solution that was there. So we had a lot of other solutions too. If you see, this is a barcode scanner attached to a shopping cart, but this is no cost consuming. If you see this scanning kiosk, this is all done by Tesco in USA. See, you can go and scan your products and then you can build it. Or virtual supermarkets, this is also done by Tesco in some of the airports in US. So this is also a very easy method. But see, on any ending note, I would like to say, you need to make your solution viable, and then you bring about what can be easily implemented at the right time so that people are actually getting used to it. Okay? There is nothing more rewarding than giving back to the society that we are living in and make a difference to the lives of people and communities. Thank you.
Validating ideas. Did you have any idea apart from the app? I mean, the point where I'm coming from is, why does every solution has to end with an app?
Yeah, not necessarily. We wanted to make the most easily implementable and the quickest solution so that the problem cannot wait longer, right? So
do you have examples of other solutions?
I think the scanning kiosks, which I showed you earlier, that was also what we thought. But when we searched in the net, it was already there, but it wasn't implementable.
Okay, let me rephrase it. Apart from technology, did you have any solution?
No. As a designer, as a technology person, you wanted to do something from the digital world for these people so that, you know, they make the process more optimized. Yeah.
Yeah, something similar to what the person is asked just now.
Yeah.
So, what I feel is people who have got the ability to scan things in the supermarket and get things through mobile application are those people who can do it from home itself. That's what I feel. So, we have this big basket day, something like that, right? We can order from home itself. Why would they go to supermarket and do barcoding stuff and all these things?
Yeah, very valid question. So there were malls in Chennai where it is connected to the IT people, the IT offices, and then there will be malls in the basements. People while going to work, or more people while they are on the breaks, they go and then they see the malls are fully occupied and then there are lots of queues and then they come out. So that is one thing which we thought should be reduced. And then coming to the elderly people, right? We actually saw a lot of people coming with their grandchildren and standing in the queues, wasting a lot of time. No, you actually know that the elderly people cannot stand for a long time, but if you see, it actually takes half an hour to 45 minutes for them to get there. So that was one more key thing which you wanted to focus on.
Sorry, one more question.
Yeah.
I think you have started with society, centricity and something
yeah,
like that.
Yeah.
But I think this case study falls under more into business solution rather than society, because it's a problem created by the business people. So what society, what we are considering, the examples which you have shown, the water bucket which they are pulling.
That is all done by the NGOs organizations which are like full fledged.
Yeah, yeah.
Just wanted to adapt that process for a simpler solution for people to understand and think about how to bring about small changes in the society with the help of designers and the design standpoint. It's what we wanted to run with.
Okay, what I meant was either the case study is not going with the title or title is not matching with the case study. That's what I meant.
Okay. So we actually have another app coming up for people to collect the food wastage also. So maybe I can explain it to you offline if you are interested.
Sir?
Yeah.
See, you have scanners to identify different quality at high speeds. You can identify registrations and all that.
Okay.
Why can't it be a simple solution like having a belt moving and you keep on products with a separate distance solution and scan them and
Sure, that would also be a solution.
See, most of the time, what I have spent research on all those things,
yeah. The
time is gone while the person taking each product, scanning manually, and feeding.
Yeah.
So, the time is wasted more by the manual information,
right.
And then bread.
Yeah.
So, what if anywhere the material is running on the conveyor belt? Why can't I create 5 items,
2 items, 4 items equally? Yeah, obviously, that would be a great solution. Yeah, sure.
And when you keep the barcode up, visible to the scanner,
yeah.
This can help. Instead of buying an app, to buy one thing on console.
Yeah.
He can't engage his mobile.
Right.
And I don't think most of the people are smart enough to use a smartphone.
So that is the reason I told you. So that is not the only solution which you can provide for this problem here. You see, there are lots of other solutions already implemented successfully in the other countries also. So it could be yours. At the end of the day, you should actually influence the society and make this community a better place to live, right? That is what the ending note of the whole presentation is about.
Yeah. Hi, Prashanth.
Yeah.
I'm Sharan.
Yeah.
That was a great solution, actually. Actually have something similar to sir sitting next to me.
Yep.
So I thought he said about the conveyor belt, right?
Yeah.
So my idea is very simple.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe just start in 2 to 3 minutes. Why can't we have a digital basket?
Yeah, sure.
While we are carrying the basket itself as a scanner,
mm-hmm.
while we drop the item into it, it scans itself. And
it's expensive solution
because you need to add a scanner to the basket. And basket is a most reduced product
right there. No, see, there are like hundreds of solutions for a single problem. There is no harm in doing it.
I'm not denying this anymore. See, everyone has their own ideas.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
We give a solution. You are not going to complicate the issue.
Yeah.
You have to give some feasibility, facility to them.
Right.
You are talking about many things.
Right.
So simpler, straight communication is this. Right. What I thought, maybe I'm not in the bottom brainstorming team or your idealistic things, and maybe I'm not smart enough to use my own smartphone. But the thing is, research means now researching the available resources. You need not start from inventing it. So you can take the available things, make it modified or usable for your convenience or making other people feel convenience. So you can't keep basket safe. There will be many items which are hard, sharp and other things. Simple number, then you keep them visible. The second time every age person can understand barcode is readable, keep it up, it will scan, make the total amount, give cash or card and take it.
Yeah, that would be awesome. So there are like,
not a problem. I'll just conclude it. So yeah, different persons have different opinions, and obviously there are different solutions as well. I won't contradict to any of the solutions. I just say my solution in a simple way. Here, the digital basket itself, it scans it, and each and every person do not have to wait all the long. And we have the technology that we have devices where we can pay the amount there itself, right? Like swiping the cards with the device, right? We have the delivery persons, right? Like e-card or card delivers us, they do the same tech, they have the same technology. They just swipe the card and they collect. So there won't be a lot of employment we need to take in. There will be less persons, they will be moving around, they'll have this card, they'll have this device, and they can just enter the basket number so that they'll get the bill out there, and they can swipe it and they can just
Sounds great. Thanks again. Yeah, so as you already saw, go ahead.
Yeah, I'm afraid we don't have time. Yeah. Thank you, Prashanth.